Here we are continuing the lecture number 10. Bheej the Euclidean space, and this notation in a parenthesis by a single comma, this notation is the inner product function upon V. If we consider any vector beta from V as a fixed vector, that means we are considering beta is fixed, and if we consider any other vector, suppose alpha, from this V, Euclidean space V, then we can find a scalar C, such type of a scalar C, for which this alpha minus C beta vector, will be orthogonal to this fixed vector beta. Here beta we have considered as the fixed vector, and alpha is any other vector from V. And for this alpha vector, we can find out such type of scalar C for which alpha minus C beta vector is orthogonal to this beta vector. Alpha minus C beta is orthogonal to beta, and this scalar C, for which this alpha minus C beta is orthogonal to beta, is called the scalar component of this vector alpha, in the direction of beta, or the component of alpha to beta. Now let us find this scalar value C. Alpha minus C beta, this vector being orthogonal to beta, we can write the inner product value alpha minus C beta comma beta, this ordered pair, the inner product value of this ordered pair, alpha minus C beta comma beta, this is equal to 0. And from the linearity property, if we expand this, this first component alpha with beta, the left hand side portion will be equal to alpha comma beta, and this second component minus C beta comma beta, this is minus C beta comma beta, this is equal to 0. And we are taking this portion in the right hand side. So this is alpha comma beta, this equal to C beta comma beta. And from the homogeneity property of inner product function, we can write this scalar outside this parenthesis. So this C beta comma beta, in this place we can write C into beta comma beta. And also we know from the positivity relation, from the positivity property of inner product function, for any non-null vector beta, the inner product value of the ordered pair beta comma beta must be a positive real number. So we can divide this beta comma beta on both sides. So from here we can write C equal to alpha comma beta divided by beta comma beta, and this is the procedure of calculation of this C, for which the vector alpha minus C beta, will be orthogonal to a fixed vector beta. Beta is a fixed vector, alpha is any other vector, and alpha minus C beta is orthogonal to beta. We have to calculate this scalar component C. C is said to be the scalar component of alpha along beta. Okay, C beta is said to be the projection of alpha, upon beta. Okay, now we shall have to merely remember a theorem. Basically, this theorem states, if we consider any collection of orthogonal vectors, Here we have considered a set of orthogonal vectors alpha 1, comma alpha 2, comma so on alpha n from a Euclidean space V. I do think you already familiar with the linear combination of vectors that have already been done in your vector space 2, in vector space 1. Here we have considered the linear span of this set of vectors alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha n. V is a Euclidean space, and from V we have considered a collection of orthogonal vectors, nonnull collection of orthogonal nonnull vectors alpha 1, comma alpha 2, so on, alpha n. And we have considered the linear span, we have considered here the linear span of this set of vectors, that means linear span of alpha 1, comma alpha 2, so on, alpha n. And we are considering a vector alpha from this linear span. This theorem states that this alpha must have a unique representation of such type, alpha equal to c1 alpha 1 plus c2 alpha 2 plus 1 cn alpha n. Alpha equal to c1 alpha 1 plus c2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus cn alpha n, where this c1, c2, so on, cn are the corresponding scalar components of alpha along this corresponding vectors. That means C1 is the scalar component of alpha along C1. C1 is the scalar component of alpha along the vector alpha 1. C2 is the scalar component of the vector alpha along the vector alpha 2. So on, Cn is the scalar component of the vector alpha along the vector alpha n. In general, what we can write, Ci are the scalar components of the vector alpha along the vector alpha I, where I varies from 1 to so on n. This theorem, merely we have to keep it in our remembrance. The proof is being beyond the scope of your syllabus. Okay.